Graphite is a carbon-based material. Graphite found in pencils is pulverized and molded with clay constituents. Graphite literally means writing stone. Colored graphite has pigmented materials added to it. In this video, we're going to look at a curious medium called Graphitint pencils, which are made by Derwent. This is the first time that I'm going to be using Graphitint pencils, so you'll get to go along on the journey with me. I'm also going to be working on watercolor paper, and I also have a couple of nylon brushes handy since we can dilute the Graphitint pencils with water. We'll begin by first drawing the outline of what we're drawing. Whenever I'm trying a new medium out, I like to stick with a subject that I'm fairly familiar with. And for me, I like drawing eyes, so we'll draw an eye here. I'm using a dark brown to begin with, just to get the basic idea of the shape of the eye on the paper. Now, one of the reasons why this medium is curious to me is because when you use colored pencils, which are wax-based, you are discouraged from using colored pencils over the top of typical graphite. This is because the wax medium in the colored pencil material mixes with the graphite that's already on the surface, causing gray areas. So these Graphitint pencils are kind of a mix between graphite pencils and colored pencils, since the base or the core of the pencil is not made out of a wax material. Instead, it's just tinted or pigmented graphite. Now, after I've laid down the initial outlines using the dark brown, I've gone back with a blue color and midnight black to start establishing some of the darker areas. I'm using a light green here to start establishing some of the greener areas that exist in the eye, trying to make marks that extend outward from the pupil, which is in the center of the eye. I'm going to layer colors as I observe them. In this case, a reddish brown is added next. A more intense blue is added after that. One thing that you'll notice about the Graphitint pencils is bright colors are not available in the set. For example, in the set that I have, there is no red. Yellow is missing as well. Orange is missing as well. In fact, it's almost, as the name implies, tinted graphite. So the colors that you use with this medium are going to be muted. This might be something that you're looking for in your finished drawing anyway. Now I'm going back with the nylon brush and I'm just adding water to the material that I've laid down on the surface. And what happens is the material becomes activated and you can move it around on the surface. After you've added water to your initial application, you can go back and intensify some of the colors. In this case, I'm making the application of midnight black here a little bit darker. Another thing you'll notice about the Derwent Graphitint pencils is that the dark colors, or in this case the black, don't ever really get black. They turn a dark, dark gray, much like what you would expect with a graphite pencil. Another thing I've noticed about using this medium is that the pencils are very, very soft, very much like a 6B or 7B graphite pencil. This means that keeping a sharp tip on the pencil is going to be a challenge, so it's a good idea to have a pencil sharpener handy. Now, the material will dry very, very quickly once you activate it with the water. So this will allow you to work very, very quickly. In fact, it's a little bit faster than using watercolor pencils, which take a little bit longer to dry, meaning that you'll have to wait a little bit longer before you layer additional layers of color over the top of the areas that have been activated. At this point, activating the second application of color that I've layered over the top. And what you'll notice is as these colors are activated, they become intensified. This means that the areas of darker value will become darker in value. The areas that are pure color will become a little bit more intense. Don't expect super intensity though, as these colors are muted because they are, after all, graphite. There is a white pencil in the set, and what I've noticed by layering over these areas with white is they almost burnish a bit, somewhat like you would expect with colored pencils, although the white doesn't totally cover the color that's underneath. So it almost changes the value, but very gradually. A good way to think about how this medium behaves is to think about color theory and color mixing in general. if you take a color and you add gray to it, you are changing the intensity of the color, you're muting the color. Well, graphite is naturally a gray color. So when you add pigment to that gray color, you're going to get muted colors. So most of the colors that are in the set here are earth tones. They're very muted colors. So you need to consider the colors that are available to you when you choose this medium. At this point, I'm using the brightest blue in the set to go back and just add a few more details to the iris around the pupil and make some of those values a bit darker. Next, I'm going to add a bit of shadow underneath the eyelid using a color that's actually called shadow. It's actually a very dark blue. I'm also going to intensify this with a little bit of the midnight black here before activating it with water. If you put a very light application of the material on the surface and then activate it with the water, you'll find that you're able to control the transitions from dark to light relatively easily. So if you're looking for a smooth transition from a very light value to a very dark value, you can accomplish it relatively easily using this medium. Now in the corner of the eye, there is an area that's pink, and this is going to be a bit of a challenge since there's not a true red in the set. Instead, this is very close to a sienna color. Much like with watercolor painting, I'm relying on the white of the paper to do some of the work for the lighter values. Hopefully, by putting down just a bit of the sienna color and then moving it around with the water, I can create the illusion of it being pink. And of course, if you put too much of the material on the surface, you can add a bit of water to it and then dab it with a paper towel to remove it. A bit of midnight black is used just to increase the contrast from the upper eyelid and the eyeball itself. Now, normally I would not use black at all, especially in a watercolor painting or even watercolor pencil painting. But in this case, since the black itself is really a dark gray, it's not really an issue. I'm also going to use a bit of brown and more of that sienna color for the upper portion of the eye, where that crease happens right above the eye itself. Again, you have to be creative with your color mixing here, since many of the colors that you would use for skin tones are not available. For example, red and yellow are absent from the set. So yeah, you kind of have to think about how you're going to use your colors and how you would think the color would translate in the overall drawing. Of course, the relationship of colors around it will help communicate the color anyway. All right, now we're going to make some of the marks for the eyelashes, and here I'll use the midnight black to do so. In this case, you want to have a very sharp tip when you're making the marks. So after every few eyelashes, I'm resharpening the pencil. That gives you an idea of how soft the graphite that's inside of the pencils is. Now, I know eyelashes can pose a real problem for some people, but a little quick tip here is just to make check marks. On the upper portion of the eye, the check marks should go down and up, and of course on the lower portion, they should kind of go up and then down. Be very loose and organic with your marks, and understand that eyelashes are imperfect. I'm going to make that area on the right side of the eye just a little bit thicker with the eyelashes using the midnight black, and then I'll activate that area using the nylon brush with a bit of water. I'll activate a few areas around the eye as well just to make the eyelashes a bit darker. Now I'm going to cheat just a little bit here, and what I mean by cheating is I'm going to use a little bit of white gouache that is not thinned out at all, and I'm just going to create a few areas of highlight. Now, to create those areas of highlight without using the gouache would have been very difficult because I would have to have avoided those areas with the material. Instead, it's a whole lot easier to go back with the gouache and go right over the top of the graphite with the gouache since it will cover it. So that was a very quick look at using Derwent's Graphitint pencils. Again, those are pigmented graphite pencils. I hope it helped you out just a bit.